Hey friends, quick plug here. Sonic Toast mascot stickers are now available at my eBay store. Link in the description below. Enjoy the video.
Greetings friends, I'm Sonic Toast, and today we're looking at Movie Bowser. So this action figure is massive, and apparently he lights up inside the mouth. So this is a massive action figure with some great pictures on the side. Apparently his mouth lights up. This is another one that I ordered from the Target website, and it came with a damaged box. So I guess it's just what happens when you get things shipped. However, I have seen this in store now. I've seen all the Mario figures in store, and they seem to be quite abundant. He blows out smoke too. Oh, we gotta get this guy open and see what he's like. Toast. All right, and boom, here he is out of the box. This guy is just massive and threatening and terrifying. Holy cranberries, what an amazing sculpt. He almost reminds me of Giga Bowser. Like, it's like the in-between normal Bowser and Giga Bowser. And let's look at the articulation on this guy, because he's got shoulder articulation and he's got elbow articulation in here, knee. Look how straight his legs go. Oh wow, great joints on the knees and twisting feet. And of course, he has moving legs. He can go in and out a little bit. And then his head doesn't quite turn. His tail, there's 2 points of articulation on his tail. Lots of twisting there. Wow, wow. When it comes to Bowser, this is probably the most articulated Bowser figure we have ever gotten. Holy cranberries. And his sculpt just looks fantastic. Look at all the detail on his shell. Look at all the texture on his tail and his legs and arms. He's all scaly, and his shell comes off apparently. I did not realize that. It is so rubbery, rubbery, rubbery shell. All right, so here under his shell is where his battery pack hides, the perfect place to put it. And then also his hair comes out. Whoa, look at that inside his head. And that is for inserting water so that it can be turned into smoke or breath or steam or whatever it is that comes out of his mouth. All right, so put in 3 AAA batteries, and I use a little tiny syringe to put like 6 drops of water. The instructions don't say how much to put in there. All right, now that I've screwed the battery cover back on, just kind of slip the shell right back on there. Doesn't really click or anything, it just sort of fits on perfectly. All right, oh wait, I didn't turn him on. Let's take that shell back off and turn him on. All right, feel turned on, Bowser. Let's see. Okay, it's turned on. Now what happens? Is there a button to push? Oh, that spike on his shell. Push that. Oh, there we go. What? What? Oh my goodness. Did you see that? Did you see that fire breath? Oh my goodness. Let's see. We gotta do that again. Here we go. You ready? King Koopa? Who is the better movie Bowser? Huh? Huh? Here we go. This is such a cool and creative feature. I can just do this all night, just keep pressing the button. Actually, no, the spike kind of hurts my finger when I press it that many times. Still, it is so cool to have like smoke breath, fire breath coming out of Bowser's mouth. Wah! That is the coolest thing ever. I've got a lot of Bowser toys, and this has got to be the coolest one. I just love it. Love it, love it, love it. Keep going all night long. Awesome. So one thing about toys like this, you know, if you're like me, you put your figures on the shelf and you just leave them there for a very long time. And you don't want to leave batteries in the figure on the shelf for a long time. You don't want to leave water in the figure either, because it can get corroded. It can get gross. Same thing with batteries. It can get all gross and leaky and corroded and destroy the toy. So if you're like me and you're just going to end up putting this guy on a display shelf, be sure to take out the batteries first and dry out the water container really, really thoroughly. Did you see that? Water came out of his mouth. He's like all drooly now. all drooly Bowser.
Crazy bears. Crazy bears. Let's take a look in the mouth. Ah, bite you.
All right, let's see here. What is in there? Oops, I didn't do it on purpose that time. So there's the light and then the little tiny like fog machine in the back of his mouth. It looks like an eyeball.
Now when it comes to size, here's how he scales up against the normal Bowser figure from Jak's Pacific. And you can see he is massively bigger. Of course, the Mario movie toys are just generally bigger than the regular 4-inch Jak's Pacific figures. So I guess it makes sense for him to be bigger here, but it is pretty cool. So if these two Bowsers were to go head to head, who do you think would win?
No, no, guys, we don't have to fight. We're all on the same team. Rawr, rawr.
You know, it's funny. I think it was like 15 years ago. I was sitting down with some friends and we were just fan casting a Mario movie. Who we think would play which character? And everybody agreed simultaneously that Jak Black would be perfect as Mario in a Mario movie. And of course that didn't happen, but it's still cool that Jak Black is involved as Bowser, the greatest and most popular video game villain of all time. I'm just saying that generally, honestly, I think Robotnik is the greatest video game villain of all time, but I think from a general audience standpoint, Bowser is probably considered the greatest. Anyway, friends, thank you so much for watching this quick little review of the new movie Bowser action figure made by Jak's Pacific. Let me know what you think of him in the comments section below. Have you picked him up for your collection yet? And have a fantastic day. Toast!